trying to go natural.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Yay! I'm happy to be finally doing a Honey's Handmade demo on this channel. I feel like I filmed it before, but I don't know why it wasn't posted. So today we're doing it. Today I'm posting this Honey's Handmade demo, no matter how it comes out. And I'm gonna review these new products, newish products that I got last Black Friday as well. So I'm starting on thoroughly shampooed hair, scalp is feeling good. Let's get to the Honey Hydration Mask and see what it does for me. So I'm starting off with this Honey Healthy Hydration Hair Mask. I'm very excited to try this. What made me excited about it was the goat's milk. Of course it has the honey and the honey quart. But I was like, goat's milk? Okay, I'll see you on the goat's milk. I have to try this. If you're Caribbean, like, goat is like a delicacy for us. Yum yum, curry, curry goat roti, but yeah. More protection, I like it. So it smells really nice. It smells like Johnson's and Johnson's baby oil. I know, right? That's super random. How is that nice and why is that even honey related? But that's what it smells like. I like it. Just, it takes me back. Anyways, the texture is like a rich cream, not super heavy, but definitely a rich cream. I like that because I thought like most of the Honey's Handmade stuff was on the light side. So it's good to find one that's kind of like richer and creamier. It still kind of spreads easily and melts into your hair. Almost too much melting. Because after I put that in, I was like, But we'll apply it everywhere and then see what it has for us. I like it to melt, but I don't like it to disappear now. So let's see what we got. So the instructions said like, make sure you detangle thoroughly and apply. So I wasn't sure if detangle thoroughly first and then apply, or apply and then detangle thoroughly. I don't know, but I wouldn't buy this for slip. Like, it has a nice creamy texture, you think it would be good for slip, but it's not good for slip at all. Like, wherever I have a tangle, I pretty much still have a tangle after applying this and after trying to get my hands through it. So there's a no on the slip, but it does spread easily kind of on the surface, like over the top. I don't know if like the slip ingredients are expensive or what, because I know these companies know what to put for slip, you know, like some slippery elm and stuff. I know they know that, so why they don't do that, like, that's the part that leaves me a little confused. I would say probably a 3 out of 10 on slip, if so much. Yeah, I get. I was gonna give it a 3 out of 10 on that snap, you know what? Okay, now I'm gonna be fair and give it like a 2.75 out of 10 in terms of slip. That's about the number. It's funny because it has a rich, creamy, like awesome texture, but it just doesn't provide slip. Like, I've never seen a moisturizing mask have the lady balls to say that, like the stones to say that, like detangle and then apply. So I just couldn't believe that's what she meant, but I think that's what she meant, because like, you know, okay, some kind of clay mask, an Ayurvedic mask, you can understand it not having slip, but a moisturizing mask with no slip, and then you tell me detangle and apply. For reals? Definitely not an instant penetrator. But so, it feels almost like something could be happening, so let me give it the 30 minutes and I'll be done. So I didn't use all, which is good. And again, like I said, the thicker consistency probably helped with that. And I hope, baby Jesus, that the leave-in has slip, because it would be like a whole can for me if the leave-in doesn't have slip. I might just give up. So let's just hope that the leave-in has slip and the gel that I'm using. Yeah. So I have this coconut water leave-in conditioner to try. Hopefully it has slip. And then I have the coconut water slip and slide glycerin free gel. So hopefully this has slip as well. Hopefully, of course, they're both moisturizing. This is not exactly watery, but definitely on the watery, like moving side. So you know how my life has been these days. Like, I hope it's not another one, but we'll see. I actually do have some of this coffee coconut curling custard from before, the video that somehow never made it onto YouTube. This is a cream, actually, not really a custard, but I just bought it out because like I'm using Honey's Handmade, this might go in the mix too somehow at some point. This is my hair after letting it sit. I do feel like it's moisturized. It's interesting because the coating, like, it still feels very buttery or waxy. I guess that's the shea butter. But even though it feels like it's still a lot on my hair, and my hair didn't shrink or the product didn't look like it absorbed any, like, it still looks like it's on top there, I still feel like it penetrated too, I hope. But it does feel good, like my hair itself feels good. I'm gonna check out the gel before I get going, just to, so I know what we're working with. And I guess we'll check it out, and then I guess we'll wash and go, I guess, unless it looks like really a no. Because the consistency feels loose in the jar as well, and I don't know if I want to deal with that for a third time. So let me just open it and we'll see. I like any kind of protection because I hate when you get something and it's damaged or whatever. Because sometimes they're nice about it, but usually it's a pain. And that can cause me to stop buying a brand real quick, so it's better for all of us if it comes as it should. I love the scent. It smells like real coconut. And it almost looks like there's coconut flakes in there. I hope that's what it is. So it is kind of light, but it doesn't look like impossible. So I'm gonna apply it. Wish me luck. Wish me a lot of luck. But yeah, I love when the coconut actually smells like that sweet kind of desiccated coconut, like sugar cake kind of coconut. That's my kind of coconut because I like sugar cake. Coconut water, not so much. So I'm loving the scent. So I'm about to do the front. Let me give you some pro tips. Now let me start rinsing, I'm thinking I'll give you some pro tips as I'm going along. So this is my hair with the mask in it. I'm gonna rinse it off and add the leave-in condition. So I'm still trying to figure out this leave-in condition because the first section I applied too much thinking it would work in, but it didn't work and it just seemed to just become even more in my hair somehow. I was a little worried that I was gonna end up with just a huge puff of white. This side, I decided to add less of the leave-in condition. It still exploded into a lot of white, like a big white foam. So I don't even know what to say. I don't even know what I'm gonna do here. I guess I'll just let fate decide how much leave-in condition ends up in my hands. But I will say lack of sleep is a problem. I hate when you're having a wash day and by the end you're all numb of hearing the snaps because it's just like so little slips, so much breakage, you just hear snap, 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 and you're just dying inside and you just get numb to it. Like that's where I'm at right now. The mask, like about a 2.75 out of 10. The leave-in went up to, maybe I'll give it a good 4, feeling generous. And the gel was decent-ish, like maybe a 7, 6.5. But nothing really had enough slip if you're a person that really needs slip. So this is my hair after rinsing the deep conditioner and before applying the leave-in. I'm gonna just apply the leave-in now. This is the texture of the leave-in. Honestly, this leave-in I would say is more of a like styling cream, twisting cream, something. Like it feels like a pudding basically. It's gonna go with whatever I pull, yes. This is the texture. And it's like really thick and it's kind of gummy. I think it does have xanthan gum in it. Some fell out, so I guess I'll consider that a save. But like, you don't feel like you put a lot at all, but once you work it in, somehow it just multiplies. So I hope it's moisturizing, because it feels like it's more into defining, and I don't know if it's moisturizing. You see how it's just kind of becoming a thick white, you know? It could be my hair too, because my hair does that sometimes. But anyways, so no matter how little you put, I feel like, cause some even fell, eh? God was like, okay, nah, that's too much. Some fell on the floor and it still did that thick white foam business. This is my hair after applying a leave-in condition, which to me I would say is more of a pudding. So I prefer to use a leave-in, a regular leave-in under this, and then just use a touch, like a fingertip of this as a kind of style or something. Yeah. So this is the consistency of the gel. It's pretty runny and it has like an interesting texture. Like I can see, like you can see little flakes in it. So, which I'm fine with, like as long as it doesn't translate to flakes in your hair. Pro tip when you're dipping the gel. Definitely, if you're dipping the gel, just kind of dip against your hands and scoop it like this instead of dipping against the edge of the jar. Because when you dip against the edge of the jar, it just falls right over the jar and down. So definitely dip against your hands when you're dipping. So one thing about the gel, even though the leave-in is kind of foamy, I feel like once you apply the gel, it kind of sucks that foam and maybe even sucks a little bit of the water. I don't think it has carbomer, but almost like that. The foaming kind of goes away once you add the gel. And the gel for me is, I would say almost a re-wet gel, but pretty much a re-wet gel. Like your hair, my hair feels like it has less water on it after I apply the gel. So this is my hair after applying the gel. Definitely big, definitely frizzy. But I do think I'm just curious to see how it dries and the moisture and everything. So I think I am gonna rock it and see. But it's already frizzy and it's already big. So, yeah. Probably be seeing a lot less gels next year. It's gonna be, and now I apply my DIY gel. Cause yeah, my gel is better than all of these gels that I've tried so far for the year. But anywho's. What we're working with so far, just in terms of the slip and the application experience, I would not repurchase these, especially seeing, like I said, when the definition isn't all that and the moisture is uncertain. Like, I'm not saying it's not moisturized, like, it's just hard to tell. That one I'll have to let you know when it dries, but yeah, given all that, I don't think I'll repurchase. At least handmade is super tempting just because the sales are like ridiculous, like 50% off or something, 60% off sometimes. So, and it's not bad, you can get your hair moisturized, but I haven't found any HGs or even any Loves really, like they're just fair to find, but you can get them at a really good price. That's my take on Honey's Handmade. Let me know what your favorite products are from Honey's Handmade. Definitely nothing to really write home about for any reason. Basically. So, yeah. So I'll come back when it dries with my final thoughts. Hi y'all, so I'm back. Hopefully not looking as sleepy as I feel, because I'm very sleepy. But anyway, this is day 3. And actually I do like how it looks. Of course, like, I wish it was more moisturized, but I do like the shape and just the kind of natural curl that I'm getting. So, like, you can see the definition in there with the frizz, I guess. So I am enjoying my look, and like I said, I wish it was more moisturized, and that's about it. So I would recommend, if you're using that gel and if you're using that leave-in condition, put a real moisturizing leave-in under it, and then like either use the condition as a pudding or use the gel. I don't know if you need both. And the gel is definitely a soft hold gel, so if you're with it, if you're not with it, kind of act accordingly. And like I said, everything could do it more slip. The condition could do it more moisture. I guess the gel could do it more moisture too. So yeah, I still haven't found anything in this brand that would make me go, ooh, I must have it. But I still do think that the conditioners are moisturizing and you can pretty much get everything to work. So with the great sales, if you kind of mix it in with good products, like if you got a really moisturizing product with good slip somewhere in the mix, you can probably make it work with the rest of her products, basically. That's my opinion. It doesn't reflect the views of this station. That's just my opinion so far on Honey's Handmade. I think I've tried at least 7 things probably, and that's my opinion so far. But let's get into some more detail. I started off with the healthy hydration hair mask, and she said don't even worry about no slip, boo. Don't even worry about no slip. Don't ask about no slip, don't worry about no slip, don't concern yourself with slip. This has no slip whatsoever. I did use more than half. I do like the scent. Johnson & Johnson baby oil, like I said. But it did give me good moisture. It did have a kind of oily feeling at the top, which was a little weird, so I did feel the moisture, but I guess the shea butter, I felt that as well, which didn't seem to affect the penetration, but it was just a little weird. But again, like I said, I think her things are really handmade and kind of maybe a little more natural than some of the natural, less natural things, so maybe all of that is in it. I wouldn't repurchase this just due to the lack of slip, but I would definitely finish it off just because the moisture is there. Maybe I'll mix it with something with good slip. Like I said, for the Black Friday haul, her ingredients list, at least on the jars, have been kind of lacking. This is what it says for ingredients. I don't know if there's anything more or less. The honey and the goat's milk is what attracted me to this. And the thing here really has slipped to talk about, I guess. And then I went on to this coconut water leave-in condition, which was strange, as I said, because you really can't use a lot. You can't use leave-in amounts, and it's not that moisturizing. So if you're trying to use a tip, which is what I would recommend, it's not gonna be moisturizing at all. If you use leave-in amount, your hair might be flaky, I don't know, it might blow up. And it's still not all that moisturizing. So this I would use as a pudding, like twisting cream, twisting butter or something. That's how I would use this. So these are the ingredients. And I enjoy the scent of this as well. So it smells like sweet coconut water or sweetened coconut flakes. I do enjoy the scent of this, and the gel smells similar. I do think it gives slight hold. So if you're looking for like a pudding, to me, because it does have some xanthan gum. So if you're looking for a little bit of moisture, a little bit of hold over your leave-in to do like some twists or something, I would recommend for that. And I think I would even do a follow-up video using this like that. And then I have the coconut water slip and slide glycerin free gel. So when I shook it, it was really loose, but it was still managed to be kind of something. So I do think it gave me at least a soft hold. There's definitely more than no hold, but my hair is big and, you know, softly defined slash frizzy, I guess you could say. But I like it. I'm not really complaining about that. If it had given me moisture too, we would have been in business. I don't see any xanthan gum, carbamopectin, anything like that. So I don't know if the wax is supposed to hold it together, the aloe gel is supposed to hold it together in terms of whole ingredient. You know. But it did alright, and I think if you put it on top of something moisturizing, it will do alright for you. So I did have this coconut custard just nearby, just in case it came in handy. So this is another one I probably want to do like some kind of twist out with or something. So if you're thinking about buying this, just note it's definitely a cream, not a custard like kinky curly or something. And it may be more moisturizing, I don't remember. Yeah, this has agave nectar and stuff. This might actually be more moisturizing. Don't remember much about using this, but don't remember complaining about dryness either. So, you know, pick your poison between the two. I think they're kind of similar products, but this may be more moisturizing, I don't know. So that's pretty much it. My first Honey's Handmade demo, I guess. I may do like one kind of braid out, twist out type demo. And then after that, I'll just probably demo some of the other conditioners. Or maybe, I don't even know if I need to demo it. Do I need to demo it, or should I just come on and say, well, yeah, that one was okay, that one was okay. I'm not even that hopeful of finding a winner to really demo them. I do have at least 6 more new conditioners to try. Will I be trying her again Black Friday? Heck yeah, if she hits us with 50-60% off, I'm gonna definitely lose my mind and be at it again and be complaining again, but that's okay. So as long as I can get some moisture from it, if she's gonna give me 50% off, I'm gonna buy it. I don't know what that makes me. A sucker for pain, I don't know. Like I think if I wasn't demoing it, I would probably add something for slip or mix it with something with slip. At least the deep conditioner. And the styler is again layered over something moisturizing and with slip. Like I think that's what I would do. And that's what I would recommend. But if you just love something in Honey's Handmade, definitely let us know below what that is so we can try it, or I can let you know if I tried it. That's it. Thank you guys for watching. And let me know what you think of Honey's Handmade down below. See you in the next one. Bye.